Hi, my name is Alan from Alan Wee Property. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to talk about condominiums in the King Albert Park vicinity. King Albert Park is located along Bukit Timah. It falls within District 21. As usual, I will randomly compare 6 condos within this stretch. I will study both freehold and 99 years leasehold development. I will also look into big and small projects, old to new ones. This will allow us to have a more holistic picture of its performance over time. Here, I'll be looking into freehold, the Cascadian, Maplewood, Jardin to KAP Residences. I'll also explore the 99 years GardenVista and Mayfair Modern. Are you curious to find out which condo will be the hit, which one will be the miss? Stay till the end. I promise you, you will definitely learn something from it. Here, let's dive straight into the details. First condo, the Cascadian, is located along Bukit Timah, 5 minutes walk to King Albert Park MRT station, near the popular schools with full condo facilities. Most importantly, it's on freehold tenure. It's a mid-sized development with 288 units. It TOP in 2010. Let's zoom into the historical chart. Back a decade ago, it was going for 1,400 to 1,700 per square feet for typical units. For those that come with an extra large patio area, their PSF is generally lower. Price continued to go up and up with the opening of the downtown line. What recession? Remember, any upcoming MRT station is always a catalyst to price growth. Today is hovering around 2,000 to 2,200 per square feet. Pretty attractive return. Let's head over to the profitable transactions. So far, there are 172 profitable and 39 unprofitable transactions. Profit range from 130,000 to 900,000. Analyzed return range from 0.4 to 5.9%. Not bad. Even a 2-bedroom can make 820,000. It's pretty impressive. As for the loose money one, they range from a low 7,000 to as much as 930,000. Wow. This is really a tale of two stories. This is surely a painful loss. Anyway, this penthouse buyer who bought this unit sure make money going forward. Remember, someone losses is another gain. When we are in Bukit Timah, how can we not compare it against Maplewood? This is the big brother in this locality, since it has 697 units and sits on 600,000 square feet of freehold land. It TOP 1997. It comprises 2, 3 and 4 bedrooms. Most units are very spacious. By looking at the size, you will know what I mean. Let's zoom into the historical chart. Beautiful. This is what I call 一条龙 in Mahjong. It just keep going up and up. Sometimes there will be bound to be some dips, but generally, such condo will appreciate over time, even if it's 27 years old. So far, there are 144 profitable and 1 unprofitable deal. Profit range from 400,000 to 2.6 million. Analyzed return all what? It range from 3 to 7%. Cannot complain really. Such return can even match GIC nominal rate of return of 5.8%. Very impressive in my opinion. That is why they are constantly sought after both by locals and expats. Let's go to KAP Residences, which is located in between Jalan Anak Bukit Flyover and Bukit Timah Road. This is a mixed development comprised of 142 apartments with a 2-story retail mall. It TOP in 2016. Let's check out the historical chart over time. Since it was launched back in 2013, there are only a handful of transactions. Volume only started to pick up in recent years. A quick look at such trend only point to one outcome. A mixed basket of winners and losers. Don't believe me? Let's take a look at the numbers. Till date, there are 21 profitable and 8 unprofitable deals. Profit range from 15,000 to 300,000. With the exceptional of that deal, most of them only achieve less than 1% in terms of analyzed return. A simple rule of thumb, anything less than 0.7% is considered as break-even after minus away all your expenses. This means that low return is as good as no return. Let's take a look at the loss-making deals. Losses range from 55,000 to 500,000. Why like that? I can only assume the layout play a part too. The location next to a noisy T-junction is almost unbearable for most. plus. F&B outlets on the lower level will no doubt have littering and fume issue. This will only point to higher upkeep and maintenance fees. Let's go across the road to Jardin. Jardin used to occupy the former Yeo's factory along Bukit Timah. It stretched along Dunyan Road on a long piece of land. There are 140 units, comprising 1 to 4 bedrooms. It was completed in 2012. Let's zoom into the historical chart. If I compare it based on the past 10 years, prices are creeping up. This is good news to most owners, as property value increase over time. However, data can be very deceiving. We will come back to this again. So far, there are 15 profitable and 42 unprofitable deals. Profit range from $22,000 to $750,000 with an annualized return of up to 5%. However, what interests me is the high proportion of misses. Let's take a look at the loss-making deals. Loss range from $38,000 to $470,000. Why like that? 42 loss-making units translate to 74% of the resale transaction are losing money. Super sian. I can only conclude the layout play a part. Since they are duplex units, part of the shorter area is used for the staircase, the internal lift, bay window to the void area above the living area. Technically, the usable area is lower by 30 to 40%. And I assume high maintenance fees with just 140 units. Those units facing the busy Dunyan Road will also face the brunt of the road noise. That is why if you look at the historical chart since day one, those who overpaid for them between 2010 to 2013 will most likely be suffering heavy losses. Next, GardenVista is located between Jalan Anak Bukit and Rifle Range Road. There are 318 apartments. It's on 99 years leasehold from 1999. This means it has a remaining lease of 74 years. It TOP in 2006. Let's check out the historical chart over time. Prices have been moving up slowly but steadily over the past 10 years, even with a depreciating lease. Steady, right? That is why certain condos in popular locations are still sought after for their unique selling points. Here, there are 160 profitable and just 7 unprofitable deals. Profit range from $340,000 to $1.4 million. Amazing, right? Analyzed returns are also healthy. Why is this so? I can only assume its practical living area is a key consideration. Look at the generous floor area, minimum wastage area. In addition, its location is within 1 km to popular primary schools. The last project and also the newest kids on the block is Mayfair Modern. It's located along Rifle Range Road, right behind the Green Corridor. It sits on the former Mayfair Garden condo that was sold en bloc and split into two projects. The other being Mayfair Garden. Mayfair Modern is on 99 years leasehold. There are 171 units, it TOP in 2022. Most of the units are small bedrooms apartments, just like in most newer condo today's. Let's zoom into the historical chart. Not too bad. From launch, prices have been moving up. Let's take a look at the resale transactions. So far, there are 20 profitable and 0 unprofitable ones. Profit range from $57,000 to $350,000. Analyzed return range from 1.3% to 5.6%. If you look closer into the numbers, the bigger units have a higher profit margin. This is not surprisingly for most resale transactions. The yield is also decent in my opinion. With mass market condo fetching 2,500 per square feet, does this mean Mayfair Modern seems like a steal? Let's sum up. Interestingly, the Cascadian doesn't seem to perform as expected with only a 10% return. This is likely because the developer are holding on to it strongly a decade ago. Moreover, there was a drop in prices from 2014 to 2016. Those who bought anything then would have made a handsome profit. As for Maplewood, it holds its prices very strongly. It has made a stunning 48% in just a decade. This is as good as any landed property return in Bukit Timah. As for KAP Residences, it fell only 6%. I can only conclude that freehold property near MRT station and near good schools are no guarantee for success. Here, I just wonder if neighborhood schools are indeed better? For Jardin, it's very disappointing to make only a 1% return in a decade with so many unprofitable transactions. I see already, I was so scared. As mentioned earlier, The inefficient layout plus road noise plus high entry prices are telltale signs. As for GardenVista, it fared an impressive 43% even on 99 years leasehold. Here, don't rule out an aging 99 years leasehold condo. It can give you a run for your money. Then, what about Mayfair Modern? It has fared 9% since launch. If you are an investor hoping to flip after SSD and TOP, is that good enough for you? Just to give you some perspective, if you have bought GardenVista back in 2019 and sold it in 2024, you have made a handsome 34% return instead. This is in line with the rise of the property market after COVID-19. Before we depart, I would like to share with you some interesting murals or legal graffiti that I came across along the footpath from the Green Corridor to Rifle Range Park under the Anak Bukit flyover. These are some beautiful art pieces I believe are commissioned by NParks to beautify this unused void area. It has definitely livened up this cold place. Here, I have a suggestion to the authority. Maybe they can allow individual donors to do a donation so that their names can be engraved into some plaques to acknowledge their donation. This will foster a sense of ownership and provide an opportunity for them to contribute back to the community. Such donation can be recycled and distributed back to the needy. This is a win-win situation. That's all. I hope you have learned something useful in this video. If you have any housing plans to market your properties in Bukit Timah, I'll be more than happy to assist you. Thank you.